your day and how you go and just say good day, good day, good day, and you'll be right.
Hey! Welcome back to the old bush shed. It's been a while, hasn't it? Hey, it's good to see you back. And your front. Don't know about seeing my front, it scares the shit out of you, doesn't it? How do you think I wake myself up in the morning? Oh, yeah. Walking in the bathroom, seriously. Oh, I'm walking in the bathroom, oh my god, you know, bloody morning. I look at, wash my face, yeah, I look up, oh Jesus! Oh, it's alright, it's just me. I'm awake now. Alright. Let's cut the shit. Alright. What are we doing? I'm back. What are we doing in the shed tonight? Well, it's bloody cold night tonight. It's only about 7 degrees out here. But in the shed, believe it or not, even though it's a tin shed, it's actually pretty warm in here comparatively to outside. And the tin shed is quite warm. I think it must be all the dust. But this is what we're going to make. Well, it's not done. I just mocked it up to show you what it's going to look like. Easy peasy, this one. So these were already cut, so I'm happy with that. Now, as you can see, this one's a little bit higher. And that one, oh, there you go. Bit of a wobble in it. Tommy kangaroo down sport. Shush. It's all right, I can fix that, I hope. And I'm gonna hopefully level that out. I'll be able to put that down there. Couple of coach bolts in there, couple of coach bolts in there, and something in the middle down there. Bloody brilliant. Should be done by the night. I hope so. Alright, let's get stuck into it. Oh, I've been looking for that. Amazing what you find in a shed, isn't it? Oh, truth, it's heavy. I ended up having to cut this down, this one here, down by 45. So, now, we're looking at around about 400 odd. And the level, it's not bad. It's not the greatest, but you know, bugger it. That's what rustic's all about, isn't it? All right, gonna mark out the holes now, drill the holes. Two holes, so I'm gonna put some coach bolts in there. Beauty, let's get into it. What you call hard wood. Wondering why I drilled a hole in the center of that. My experience with hardwoods is that if you drill the hole for your coats, just that little bit too small, the old hardwood literally grabs hold of it. And you can't get the bastard out. I mean that literally. It can either go 3/4 of the way in and leave it out and it's a real mongrel, or it will literally shear. So I'm going to try one at 6 and try that and see how we go. If it works on a 6, I'll be happy. 6.5. Ripper. I'm going to paint the top down. Okay. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go out there and I'm not going to sand it. I'm just going to run a wire brush on a grinder all over it. Get the crap and everything off it, and I just want to leave it with the old saw marks on it. So you don't need to watch me do that. I'll be back in a minute. All right. There we go. All done. Left that rustic look on it. I think it looks good. Now I've got to do the legs. See how we go. There we go. Still kept that rusticness in it, didn't I? Hey? Hey? I think it looks bloody brilliant. What I think. Yeah. Let's get this bolted together a bit. We'll see how we go, eh? Alright. Can't see a bloody thing. Hello. I can see you now. Alright. I'm going to drop this back up here. I'm going to bolt it in. Here. Let's try. Right. Let's have a look at it. There you go. I'll tell you what.
Well, how bad is it, hey? Right. Here we go.
Hey.
There's the legs. There's one leg. Look at that. Beautiful. Oh. There's the bottom. There's the other leg. See how I kept the
old sore marks in there? No, this bloody beautiful knot. Oh, there it is. Oh, there it is there.
All right, and it's up there too, see?
Oh, there we go. Lovely. All right,
I'll pop you back over. Keep on keeping on.
It's what they used to say, yeah.
A screwdriver in a hole is your best mate. Behave. I don't mean that, behave.
Looks like I might have to put a little bit of carry packer in there. But otherwise, turn out a bloody tree, don't it? Let's get these bolts out, put the washers in, and we'll be right. Put a bit of glue in the old hole. It was a good idea putting glue in there. Main reason being is that way no nuts are not going to come out. There we go. Bloody well finished it. I'll be back in. Excellent. Well, it's not finished yet. It's got to be oiled. I'll tell you what. Got to be happy with that, don't you? Have a look at it. Look at that. Gorgeous. I didn't think it through too well, did I? Got to get that down there. Shit. Right. Thought it was heavy before. It's going to be a bloody monster now. Right. Come for a walk. There it is. It's on the ground.
Let's have a bit of a sit.
I reckon that's alright, Dad. Kinda, it's actually quite comfy.
Alright. Time to oil it. I'll come back when it's all oiled. Put some photos up. And we'll go from there.
You don't need to watch me oil it, do you? Keep looking at the channel. Of course, you've got the Bush Shed Facebook. Okay, make sure you look at that. Instagram, the Bush Shed, the Bush_the_Bush_Shed. I'm on Instagram now. And make sure that you pop along to Instagram. Have a little bit of a look-see. Take care of yourself. Till next time, hooray.
To be an Aussie, whenever you're stuck, for what to say, if you want to be dinky-dye, why don't you give it a try?